Hey folks, I'm Kevin Roth, and I'm glad you tuned in. This is the first online dulcimer concert that I've given. Kind of strange in a 50-year career, but here we are. I'm in beautiful San Diego with a bunch of dulcimers and my little dog Bosco and my cup of coffee and my artwork and all kinds of wonderful things to keep my mind occupied during this coronavirus outbreak. Hopefully you're seeing this at a time when not only do you need to see this, but maybe hopefully the coronavirus is over. So I thought I'd play you a bunch of songs that I really love. And this first song is from one of my favorite movies of all time. And then I go into a song that I wrote, which you'll see makes a lot of sense, segued. It's from an album called The Deviant Dulcimerist. And I'm playing it on this instrument called the guitar simmer, which I'll tell you about a little bit later on. Kansas, he said, what kind of person decides to move there? I said, I got a feeling it'll be a respite. I'm packing up my Toto and all my affairs. I said, I got a feeling all kinds of things are gonna turn around and come around and be what I need. Just like Dorothy landing in Oz, riding the tornado into make-believe. Dorothy, are you there? I could use some company. Don't forget to leave those slippers for me. I need a fast track to making my way back from the Lion and the Scarecrow and that Tin Man. Well, it all turned into quite a cosmic Kansas. Who would have guessed? Who could have known? And no one would believe this crazy life I'm living between the yellow brick road and the Twilight Zone. Dorothy, are you there? I could use some company. But don't forget to leave those ruby slippers for me. I need a fast track for making my way back from the Lion and the Scarecrow and that Tin Man. I don't mind the man behind the curtain. Smoke and mirror is his game. Take the time to find an answer. Isn't that the reason that you came? Don't forget to leave those ruby slippers for me. Pennsylvania. I need a fast track for making my way back. I'm the Lion and the Scarecrow and that Tin Man. Dorothy, are you there? I could use the company. Don't forget to leave those ruby slippers for me. I need a fast track for making my way back. I'm the Lion, Scarecrow and that Tin Man. That's Dorothy, which I wrote with my friend Noel Paul Stuckey. He's the Paul in Peter, Paul, and Mary. For an album that we did together, he produced it with dulcimer and synthesizer. It was a real interesting album called Reawakening. Probably one of the most interesting records I've made. And I did that while I was living in Kansas City, Missouri. So this is a guitar simmer, and it was made by Ken Miller. He's a retired luthier, but holy Moses, did he make an instrument that was so unbelievably gorgeous. I mean, this thing is just a pleasure to play. And this is the instrument I normally tour with. It's actually a Weisenborn guitar with dulcimer frets. Gotta have my caffeine. And it's just really beautiful. So here's a song that popped into my mind a couple weeks ago. I was reading something on Facebook from a dulcimer player who was out there basking and complaining about how difficult it is for artists to make a living nowadays. Well, it's never been easy unless you're really a big name. And he was feeling pretty lonely. And I don't know why the song came to me, because I've never sung it before. It was never a favorite song, but it popped into my head. So I recorded it for him and emailed it to him. And then I liked it so much, I thought I'd sing it for you. It's a good song for these days, or for any days. I wish you bluebirds in the spring, a lovely song for your heart to sing, and then a kiss, and more than this, I wish you love. And in July, a lemonade to cool you in some leafy glade. I wish you health and more than wealth, I wish you love. My broken heart, and I agree that you and I could never be, but with my best, my very best, I set you free. And I wish you shelter from the cold, a cozy fire to keep you warm, but most of all, when snowflakes fall, I wish you love. Set you free. I could hear Rosemary Clooney singing that. One of my favorite singers, Rosemary Clooney. Gordon Lightfoot song for you. In the early morning rain, with a dollar in my hand and an aching in my heart and my pocket full of sand, I'm a long way from home. And I miss my loved one so. In the early morning rain, and no place to go. Out on runway number 9, big 707 set to go. But I'm stuck here on the grass, where the cold wind blows. Well, looking tastes so good, and the women all were fast. Well, there she goes, my friend. She's rolling. Hear the mighty engine roar. See the silver ring on high. She's away and westward bound. Far above the clouds she'll fly, where the morning rain don't fall and the sun always shine. She'll be flying o'er my home in about 3 hours' time. This old airport's got me down. It's no earthly good to me, 'cause I'm stuck here on the ground, cold and drunk as I can be. You can jump a jet plane like you can a freight train, so I'd best be on my way in the early morning rain. Well, I'd best be on my way in the early. Gordon Lightfoot. Well, I'm going to switch out dulcimers here. This dulcimer is a dulcimer that was built for me by a guy named David Field, who is no longer with us, but he was a luthier, dulcimer maker that never really got his due. He made great dulcimers, man. He was from New Jersey. And if you have any of my early albums, especially on Folk Bay Records, this is the dulcimer that's on all the covers. Man, it's good coffee. I have it capoed. It's made of spruce, actually it's cedar and rosewood. And I've had it a very, very long time. I think he made this in, it's 169, I think he made it, must have made it around 1974. No, 72, because I made my first record in 74. I'm going to play an instrumental, but a lot of people really love of mine. It's called Dry Bones, and I wrote it in Henniker, New Hampshire during a winter storm. And it's really sort of an exercise in rhythm and syncopation and chords and things like that. And I hope I get through this without strings breaking, because they're a little on the old side. Dry Bones. Break a string on me. David Field's five-string dulcimer. The very first dulcimer I ever saw was a David Field played by a friend of mine, Ann Stokes, who I met in 72. We're still really good friends. She was sitting in a kitchen playing Simple Gifts, a Shaker song, which is a beautiful song. So a lot of people like the very first album I ever made. The dulcimer playing is pretty good on that. The singing, not so good, because I was 15 when I made it. It's on Folkways. Folkways Smithsonian Records, which you can Google. They're a wonderful record company. I did about 12 albums for them from 72 to maybe 82. And it was run by a guy named Moses Ash, who had Pete Seeger, Woody Guthrie, actually had a record by Bob Dylan, part of it, when he was Blind Boy Grunt. Many, many, many folk musicians, and he was a historical collector, and I had the honor of really knowing him. He signed me as a dulcimer player when I was very, very young. I sent him a tape, And he wrote back a letter saying, I like your dulcimer playing. Can you send me more pieces? So for about a dozen years, I kept making records for him. And all of those records and every record that he's ever made, is part of the Smithsonian Folkways collection and always will remain in print. And that is amazing. So hats off to Mo Ash and the guys who are still running Folkways. But there's a song in there that everybody really loved. It was written by a lady named Jean Ritchie, who was sort of the dulcimer oracle. And I thought I'd sing this song for you. It's called the LNN Don't Stop Here Anymore. It's a coal mining song, I think one of the best written. At the time she wrote it, she wasn't allowed to copyright it under a woman's name, so she did under Than Hall. The LNN Don't Stop Here Anymore. When I was a curly-headed baby, my daddy set me down upon his knee. He said, son, you go to school and learn your letters. Don't be no dusty miner like me. For I was born and raised at the mouth of the Hazard Holler. The coal cars come rumbling past my door. But now they're standing rusting, rolling empty, and the LNN don't stop here anymore. I used to think my daddy was a black man with script enough to buy the company store, but now he goes downtown with empty pockets and his face as white as a February snow. I was born and raised at the mouth, the Hazard Holler. The coal cars come rumbling past my door. But now they're standing rusting, rolling empty, and the LNN don't stop here anymore. Last night I dreamt I went down to the office to get my payday like I'd done before. But those cutsy vines were covering up the doorway, and there were weeds and grass growing right through the floor. Oh, I was born and raised at the mouth, the Hazard Holler. And the coal cars come rumbling past my door. But now they're standing rusting, rolling empty. LNN don't stop here anymore. I never thought I'd learn to love the coal dust. I never thought I'd pray to hear the tipple roar. But Lord, how I wish the grass would change to money and fill my empty pockets once more. I was born and raised at the mouth of the Hazard Holler. The coal cars come rumbling past my door. But now they're standing, rusting, rolling empty. And the LNN don't stop here anymore. I write a lot in songs in the dulcimer, and I have this thing called Patreon. This is the little commercial, I guess. Patreon is a place where you donate a certain amount of money each month to artists of all kinds and musicians to help them do what they do. And then we send you out stuff every month or weekly, however it is. And I just recorded this song for my Patreon customers. The website is www.patreon.com/KevinRoth if you want to participate. During this coronavirus, there's really kind of no minimum. You could pay $5 or whatever you can afford, and then I send things out pretty often. I sit down every morning on my couch with a cup of coffee and my dog, and I compose stuff and I record them and I send them out to you in audio form, sometimes video. And a couple weeks ago, I was noodling around and this song came to me. It's an instrumental, it's kind of a dulcimer suite, and it's called Ajata Sunyata.
Thank you.
Jada Sunyana. A lot of people have told me that they thought, or they read somewhere, that one of my influences on playing the and getting involved in the dulcimer when I was 14 was Richard Fregna. Well, I like his playing, but he wasn't an influence on me at all. The first one I ever heard play dulcimer besides Anne was Joni Mitchell. And I lived out in the country, so I wasn't exposed to any music. I didn't really know about Gene Ritchie or any of the dulcimer people, really, for almost a year and a half. And then when my first album came out in 74, it was just at the wave of the dulcimer boom. One of the guys way back then started to build and play dulcimer, and he built me this as pretty much a gift. His name's Jerry Rockwell. And one of the things I love about this dulcimer is Jerry is a tremendous player and a tremendous friend of mine. And although I have a lot of instruments by builders who are not players that are very nice, there's a real difference when someone who is a player builds an instrument, because there's certain delicacies and subtleties that come with that kind of work. And this is one of my favorite dulcimers. We call it Uncle Eddie because of Ed Thomas. The frets are, hearts are upside down. And I wrote almost the entire album, The Deviant Dulcimerist, which was the first record I ever put up there for a Grammy Award. Honestly, and I think that was my 48th album. I love that record so much. So I thought I'd play you a Joni Mitchell song. You know, Joni saw dulcimer at a folk festival built by a friend of mine, Joellen Lapidus, and I have one of her dulcimers here, but I won't be playing it in this video. I have dulcimers from all over the world here. But Joni got this dulcimer from Joellen, and she took it to Crete and wrote most of the album Blue. If you haven't heard the album Blue, what are you waiting for? It's a tremendous record. Joni Mitchell's like the Picasso of lyrics. And she came back and she recorded those songs. But this next song is not a dulcimer song of Joni's. This is actually a song she wrote on the guitar. And as we think about our lives these days, I thought this was a really good song to play for you. It's called The Circle Game, and you can sing with me. You can sing the melody or the harmony. You can really sing a whole nother song. It doesn't matter. I can't hear you. Yesterday, a child came out to wander. Caught a dragonfly inside a jar. Fearful when the sky was full of thunder, and tearful at the falling of a star. And the seasons, they go round and round, and the painted ponies go up and down. We're captive, a carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came, and go round and round and round. Circle game. 16 springs and 16 summers gone now. Cartwheels turn to car wheels through the town. And they tell him, take your time, it won't be long now. Before you drag your feet and slow the circles down. And the seasons, they go round and round. Painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on a carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came and go round and round and round in the circle game. So the years spin by and now the boy is 60. Oh, the dreams have lost a little grandeur on the way. But there'll be new dreams, maybe better dreams, and plenty before the last revolving year is through. And the seasons, they go round and round. Painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on the carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came and go round and round and round. Round and round and round, we go round and round and round in the circle game. The circle game with a few senior moments thrown in there, I think I got all the lyrics right. Well, I thought I'd sing you one more song. When I was living in Missouri around 2015, my life sort of fell apart and then came together with a lot of work and a lot of effort and a lot of luck. And I moved to San Diego to start life over. And I'm currently working on a new project, which is probably launched by the time you see this. It's called What Really Matters. And this is one of the songs that I wrote when I first got to San Diego. Because in thinking about what really mattered to me, because I was given an incorrect death sentence, actually. So for a short period of time, I had to really think about what mattered. I thought I only had a few years to live, and obviously they were wrong, because it's 2020 and I'm perfectly happy and healthy, thank God. But there were two things. One was to remain creative, and the other was to hang out with my dog, Bosco, who's in the bedroom under the covers, because it's a little chilly here today. So I wrote this song about Bosco. I posted a picture of Bosco on my Facebook page, and my sister contacted me. She doesn't like dogs or cats, or she doesn't really like too many people. And she said, you know, if you keep posting pictures of you with that damn dog, you're never going to meet anybody. And I said, you know, darling, I can't meet anybody as nice as my dog. You see, so like, I'm good. I'm good. This is called Crazy Love. They're big and round and sweet colored chocolate brown. Our love was a sweet surprise. Oh, some people say I'm crazy, maybe, who knows? All I know is I love you, baby, I'm glad that it shows. And angels show up in unusual ways. fell in love and you carried my heart away. Crazy Kevin. So thanks for watching. I'm blown away by the amount of people who wrote to me and were excited about me doing this. And if you want to reach out to me, you can through Facebook, I guess, or through this link, you can leave a comment. And if you want to find out more about my project, What Really Matters, which helps people find out what really matters and create a life worth living, give me a shout. I'd love to talk to you. So I wish you peace and all those groovy little things that Southern California people wish you and all around the world. And take a breath. You know, we're going to get through this virus. Just use your head and don't flush things down the toilet, no pun intended, that aren't supposed to be there except toilet paper. And just breathe and know that everything's going to be okay, because it always ends up being okay. So take care of yourself and take care of others around you. Thanks again for watching. And maybe I'll do this again sometime.